Yes, oh, that's all praise.
Okay.
Testing, testing. Testing, testing.
Good morning. Welcome to the house of the Lord. The house of the Lord being where you are right now, remembering that our bodies are the temple of the Holy Spirit. It's now time for our weekly announcements. Those of you who have an insert, you can follow along. If you're watching virtually, all of the announcements can be found in there detailed in the website. You just click on upcoming events. Also, you can put in your prayer requests there. You can also find all of the links for the Zoom sessions right there where it says upcoming events. So everything can be found virtually on our website. Quickly going over some of the activities and things that are coming up. Operation Christmas Child boxes are due back today. So if you just cross your mind, if you can run them by the church sometime today, that'd be greatly appreciated. The drive-through grocery giveaway is this coming Saturday. The time of that giveaway is from 11 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. this coming Saturday. Next Sunday, the 22nd, we'll have our contemporary worship service. That'll be a streaming service at 12:30. We have a number of events to help those struggling with the holidays, the LCC Divorce Care class that's going on, and also Surviving the Holidays. Both of these classes are virtual. The Surviving the Holidays is a one-day class that is this Saturday, November the 21st. A lot of things are going on this Saturday. The men's breakfast is this Saturday. That's at 9 a.m. virtually. The women's fellowship breakfast is November the 28th. And also, Kim Logan, our women's fellowship director, want to thank all of you ladies that came by to pick up your swag bags. She said it was so great to see you, and I saw a number of you as well. So it was wonderful seeing you guys drive through, waving, playing the music. So it was a great celebration of the women of the church coming together. And also yesterday, we had another church member reach the ranks of Eagle Scout, Andre Jackson. So congratulations to him. You see this beautiful flower arrangement for those of you who are here in the sanctuary. And that is to celebrate Mrs. Velda Turner's birthday. She's celebrating her birthday tomorrow, November the 16th. If you think about it, reach out to Miss Turner and give her a wonderful happy birthday. Thank you. And then we have one prayer request that's listed on the bulletin, but of course, we have many, many prayer requests, such as that for this nation and what we're going through as a world with this COVID virus. But the one that's listed in the bulletin is PJ Maz's mother, Nadine Clark, passed away this past week, and there was a private service held. So keep PJ, keep the Mazza family, keep the Clark family in your prayers. There's an address listed there in the bulletin, or you can contact the church office if you would like to send cards of condolences. Well, we're going to begin this morning's worship service with our senior pastor, Pastor Jack Morris, bringing the welcome and invocation.
Good morning. Welcome to the house of the Lord. I'm glad to see you. All of you are here. And those of you who are streaming, it's so good to be together. I've missed all of you. Missed you so much. But in our hearts, we're still one. We're still together. People of the Lord, brothers and sisters in Christ. Al Corinne is at home, and P.J. Mazza is with her. They came, the Mazzas, a little earlier. P.J. volunteered. I had no idea that anybody would do what she did. And that was to tell me that I could go to church and preach and do what I needed to do. And she would stay there and stream. So Corinne is even streaming today, along with all of the rest of us who are streaming. I had brought her home from the hospital again last evening. Minister Mazza, Minister Hooper, is prepared to preach if I couldn't make it, and I didn't know whether I was going to make it or not. It's been different here recently, and there will be some mornings perhaps I won't be able to make it, but you understand. We'll pray. We're going to get through this, just like we're going to get through everything else, and we're going to come out in victory in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. He's our God. He is our God. Praise be to the Lord. And so we're going to worship God in spirit and in truth today. The Lord is in his house. And we will love him with our hearts and with our words. So, okay. Let's bow before the Lord, invoking his blessings. Father God, how thankful we are to be in your house today with your people, whether they're in their house. Their house is the house of God. This house, 1701 Enterprise Road, is the house of God. We're so thankful, Lord, that we can be here today with you and with our brothers and sisters, because we're always with you. You're always with us. What a Savior. What a wonderful Savior. What a wonderful life. What a wonderful God. We have been redeemed. We belong to the kingdom of God. We know in whom we have believed. So bless today. Bless all who are sick and afflicted, who are hurting. Bless Corinne. Be with her. Strengthen her. Keep her. Watch over. Help her, Lord, as she views the service on the computer, that she'll feel your power, your presence, and know she's in the house of God. Bless PJ. Thank you, Lord, for this woman of mercy and grace. Bless her, I pray. Encourage her heart. Thank you for her, Lord. Thank you for all the people and all the cards that are being sent in. God, we are so blessed to have such a wonderful church and a wonderful fellowship. Lord, thank you. What a wonderful life this is, serving you, loving one another in the body of Christ. We give you praise in Jesus' holy name. Let us all say amen. 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 Thank you.
Let us stand for the morning prayer and the Lord's Prayer. If you're at home, you may even want to kneel before the Lord as we pray this prayer together, because we have so much to pray for, so much to give thanks for. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Oh, holy Lord, you are worthy of all of our praises. You reign in majesty above us and are our Lord forever. We thank you for allowing us to be graced by your presence today. Hallowed be thy name. Accept our love and adoration in Jesus' name. We are here to pray, Almighty God, that you always light our way with your presence. Help us to resist evil. We pray that your light will always shine on us and through us, dear Lord. May all people see your glory through us and come to worship you as a living God because of how we worship you, dear Lord, and they see our worship before you, dear Lord. We lift up our First Lady. We lift up Corinne. We lift up Pastor. We lift up those who have lost loved ones to COVID and other health issues, dear Heavenly Fathers. They mourn the loss of their dear loved ones, dear Lord. We pray for those that are sick and shut in, that are hurting from various different reasons, dear Lord, and not just those that are outwardly physically sick, but mentally sick, dear Heavenly Father. We pray for them, dear Heavenly Father. We pray that you give us all peace in what's going on in this world today. Give us peace in the midst of this valley. Give us peace in the midst of COVID. Give us peace in the midst of all other illnesses and ailments, dear Heavenly Father. Give us peace in the transition of government here in this country, dear Heavenly Father. Let us know that you are on the throne. There's no transition, dear Heavenly Father, because you have been king and you will always be King and Lord Almighty, dear Heavenly Father. We pray for racial harmony in this country, dear Lord. Give us peace even through these struggles, dear Heavenly Father. You are a compassionate and gracious God of all tribes and all tongues will one day acknowledge Jesus as Lord. And we acknowledge that now, dear Heavenly Father. We proclaim that your word is truth, dear Lord. We are all created in your image, dear Heavenly Father. And too easily we allow division based on culture, language, race, and even political affiliation separate us, dear Lord. But nothing can separate us from the love of Jesus, dear Lord. Let us stay connected to the vine where that love is, dear Heavenly Father. And let us show others that love, even in the midst of their hatred, dear Heavenly Father. We come before you today as we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples and us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. Minister Mazz is now going to come and read this morning's scripture reading.
Good morning. We have a number of select scriptures this morning, and I will be beginning with the Gospel of Matthew, the 6th chapter, verse 27, and then chapter 10, verse 29. Hear the word of the Lord. Can any one of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your life? And then we go to Matthew 10:29. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground outside your Father's care. And now we go over to the book of Psalms, Psalm 107:2 and Psalm 84:3. Let the redeemed of the Lord tell their story. Psalm 84:3. Even the sparrow has found a home, and the swallow a nest for herself, where she may have her young, a place near her altar. And may God bless to our understanding the reading and hearing of God's word. And now we want to welcome a minister, Francine Brooks. She is doing a special selection this morning. No, not one.
Thank you. like the lowly Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. And no one else can heal all of our soul's diseases. No, not even one.
No, no. not one. Amen.
That is beautiful. God's word is beautiful. God's church is beautiful. Now, I may have to drink some of this water to get some composure this morning. And it's not because necessarily I'm thirsty, but a friend of mine, I don't know whether I can talk or not, but Reverend Harry Jackson Jr. Have you heard of Harry Jackson Jr.? Yeah. He pastored Hope Christian Church, a mega church in Beltsville. We were on a talk television show many years ago together as a team. He's only 66 and he passed away. And well, maybe I can't say any more about it, but I think it, Dwayne, I don't know whether they're going to do it or not. You better come on up here and just sit down for just a moment. I get too emotional sometimes, and I can't talk, but I think of Reverend Jackson's wife. I think of the church. He built a great, great church. But he's in heaven now. But he was a great man, wasn't he? Great man. He's playing one of my very favorite songs, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. And getting ready for church this morning, I tried to explain to Corinne what was going on. And she said, if you're going to church, I'm going to church. I said, no, you can't go today. PJ's coming. She's going to take care of you. And I'm going to go to church. But if I get her out here in a day or two, I mean, in a Sunday or two, I'm going to do it. Because there's no place like LCC to Corinne. And all the cards that have been coming in. And I told her, I said, look at all these cards, all these emails. I said, the people love you. I said, you know why? Because they know you love them. I've often said, no one loves LCC more than I do. But I think she does. She loves the house of God. She loves the people of God. Well, okay. Well, I'm going to try. Okay. Maybe you better just stay here. Amen. Phil just read it to you, but In every one of these verses, there's a reference to a bird or to a sparrow, for the most part. Listen to these. Let me go through them real fast. Even the sparrow has found a home, a place near your altar, O Lord Almighty, my King and my God. I watch, and I am as a sparrow alone upon a housetop. Are not five sparrows sold for 2 pennies, yet not one of them is forgotten by God? You are worth more than many sparrows. He's talking about you. Are not 2 sparrows sold for 1 penny, yet not one of them will fall to the ground apart from the will of your Father? Look at the birds of the air, yet not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. Are you not much more valuable than they? Let's hold our Bibles up. Let's say, this is the word of God. Let's put it over our heart, your cell phone or your hand. Pray after me. Thank you for your holy word, Father. To whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Thank you for your holy word. Holy Spirit, plant the word of God in my heart this morning. Thank you for your holy word. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. You've heard that song, haven't you? His eye. He's watching over the sparrows, and he's watching over each one of us. We're not out of his sight. We never have been. We never will be out of his sight. He knows everything that is going on in your life, in my life. He knows everything. He doesn't miss a thing. He knows everything. And I want you to think about it today as I preach this message, that whatever is happening to you, your family, your life, your finances, you physically, emotionally, whatever, he knows about it. He knows about it. But he wants you to talk to him about it so that he can move in that situation and two of you be together on that particular issue. Oh, if I could only make this happen today. What am I referring to? Getting the word across to you that he knows your loneliness, your sadness, your disappointment. He knows his eye is on the sparrow. And would you go ahead and put the picture up of the sparrow? He knows that little tiny bird. Look at that little bird. I looked at that, I thought, that's Corinne and me. That's you. That little sparrow, insignificant. Now notice this. He didn't say his eye is on the eagle, the mighty bird. He didn't say his eye is on the nightingale. He's on that little bird that most people think very insignificant and amounts to nothing. No contribution at all that I can think of. But he knows that sparrow. And if he knows that sparrow, he knows you. And he's going to bless you, and he's going to help you and care for you. His eye is on the sparrow. Ethel Waters, you may remember her. It's been a long time ago. She made that song very popular by singing it numerous times at the Billy Graham Crusade. His eye, and I used to watch it before television became in color, it was black and white. Ethel would sing, and oh, she would inspire thousands of people. Oh, I want you to be inspired today. His eye is on the sparrow. Let me tell you a little bit about that hymn. I believe the name, let me see the name, if I want to pronounce it correctly. I might mispronounce it. I don't want to do that. Sevilla. Sevilla and her husband, William, were traveling in the state of New York. And they became very dear friends of a couple named Doolittle. And Sevilla referred to the Doolittles as saints of God. That means people who have been saved, set apart from the world, whose names are written in the book of life. She said they're saints. And now Mrs. Doolittle had been confined to the bed for nearly 20 years. She couldn't get out of bed for 20 years. Not 20 days or not 20 hours. 20 years this woman was confined to the bed. And her husband, Mr. Doolittle, had a business, but he was confined to a wheelchair in New York. And Sevilla and her husband would go visit them so often. You know, we get inspiration from one another. People said, well, you know, that. You know I'm there. No, I don't. If I don't see, I don't know you're there. No, if you don't see me, you don't know I'm here. No, we have to see, but God sees all of us. And so we love one another. We get inspiration from one another. We draw strength from one another. The church is one, not a divided church. Not a divided church. How the devil has pulled the wool over so many people's eyes, and they're criticizing their own church. Can you believe that? Well, it's true. But thank God for those who are steadfast and faithful, who love God. You know, love covers a multitude of sins. You don't go around and talk about somebody else's faults or mistakes. No, love covers a multitude of sins. And if those sins aren't covered, and if you're remembering them, and if you're talking about them, then you don't have love. That's what the Bible says. Well, this Mr. Martin and Mrs. Martin, Sevilla, they were evangelists. And they drew their strength from these two people who were confined to a wheelchair and to a bed. They would go there. You know, there are certain people I just like to get around once in a while. I don't know whether I talk to them or not, but if I just see them, it just blesses me. You know what I'm talking about, don't you? There are just certain people, the salt of the earth, the light of the world. You just draw from them energy. And the Martins went by their home, and they became dear friends. And Mr. Martin, the evangelist, asked the Doolittles, what is the secret of your hopefulness? How can you be so hopeful, so optimistic, 20 years in a bed? And you're confined, you have to propel yourself to work in a wheelchair? You can't get out of the wheelchair? How can you be so optimistic? And Mrs. Martin spoke, no, Mrs. Doolittle spoke up and said, his eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. That just came out. And from that, Sevilla wrote the lyrics to this song. Friend, be encouraged. Be encouraged. God cares for you. He loves every one of us so deeply and so greatly. Let us love one another, even as he has loved us. You know, one person I heard say one time, how did they put that? I love you, and there's not a thing you can do about it. Until that person crossed them, or made a mistake, or did something that they didn't think they should do. Friend, our love works when everything else is working. But his love worked while we were yet sinners. He loves us. He couldn't love us more. He'll never love us less. Our Savior, our God. You remember Condoleezza Rice? You remember, what was she, the Secretary of State at one time? And she was an avid football fan. And I believe it was either 2002 or 2005, there was a football game. What was that game in Florida at that time? Dwayne, you ought to know this one. I'm surprised. Was it the Orange Bowl? Yeah, it was the It's 1905. What am I talking about? She went to that football game and enjoyed it. And it was New Year's Eve. After the game, Condoleezza went back to her hotel suite, and she had some of her friends with her. And it was midnight, and they had had a late dinner, and then they laughed and talked for a while. And now the party was about to break up, and Condoleezza Rice got all of her friends together, and she said, "Let's stand in a circle." And they all held hands, and Condoleezza prayed for them New Year's Eve. And after she prayed for them, she led them in. "His eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me." Friend, your Christianity doesn't stop on holidays or football games or anniversaries. My Christianity, may it be 100% for the Lord Jesus all the time, serving God and doing the will of the Lord with all of our hearts. Jesus said this, "Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Are you worth more? You are worth more than many sparrows." I mean, God has a high opinion of every one of us, even though we may not have done very much. That little sparrow didn't do very much that you saw a picture of, or you'll see flying around on the parking lot or by your house. I look at those little sparrows often. Now I do. I look at them and I think, "Lord, you see that little bird. As far as I know, it's worthless. But you know when one of them goes down, you never take your eye off that little bird. And now you tell me I'm worth much more?" Praise God forevermore for his grace and for his mercy. You see, friend, God values you. And he even said that the hairs of your head are numbered. Now, what is he trying to say to us? What is God saying to us in these scriptures? He is saying this, that the smallest detail of your life is important to him. The smallest detail. What you think is insignificant is not insignificant to him. His eye is on the sparrow. Corinne has been in the hospital several times. She's gone unconscious. I've had to shake her, pat her face, shake Corinne, "Wake up, wake up." Call 911, get the ambulance to the house. And then it happened again yesterday. But the first time it happened, we got her down to the hospital, Anne Arundel Medical Center. And my daughter was here. She's a great Christian lady. My daughter was here. Thank God she was here. I'll tell you, sometimes you can feel like you're just about as alone as alone can be, but we're never alone. We're never alone. Go ahead and tell yourself that when you start feeling alone. "I'm not alone. His eye is on the sparrow." You speak that out, those affirmative words, and you will experience God's power right then and there at that very moment. Well, there I was down there trying to get her into that hospital, and they were doing what they could as fast as they could. And then they told me, they said, "Well, your daughter has to leave. She can't stay in this waiting room." And I thought, well, she's the only one here I know. I need her. She has to leave. She can go out into the parking lot and sit in the car. That's as high rise. It's so cold out there and all alone. Go out. She came all the way from Georgia and she has to go to the parking lot and sit in the car. I understand. They were right. But that didn't seem right to me at the moment. And then I remembered. Phil Mazza said he was going to be in Annapolis sometime today. So I took my cell phone and I called. I said, "Phil, where are you?" He said, "I'm in Annapolis." I thought, "Oh, thank God." I said, "Can you come and pick Rebecca up and take her home? She's alone now. She's all alone." And Phil said, "I'm only 5 minutes from the emergency entrance." You know, I believe God does little insignificant things like that. And then evening came. We were still in ER. And here is Tracy and Jay Franklin. Jay had a procedure done that he was getting ready to go home. They saw Corinne, you know, being wheeled down the corridor, recognized her. They came by the room that had a glass in it, looked in, saw me in there. It was evening, late. I was tired. I don't know whether I was hungry or not. But they go out and get a chicken salad meal for me, iced tea, brought it in. His eye is on the sparrow, and God knew I was in that room and more than likely needed something to eat. And here they come. Friend, God's going to take care of us, whoever we are, wherever we are. He knows you. He knows your need. He knows where you are. He's never taken his eye off of you. You see, he redeemed you with the blood of Jesus. He paid an awesome price to bring you into the family. You know what you pay something, what something cost you, and when it cost you more than something else, you value what is high priced. You couldn't have come at a higher price. The currency of heaven is the blood of Jesus to save you and to bring you into the kingdom of God. What are you worth to the Lord? Do you think he's going to pay a price like that with the blood of his only begotten son and then overlook you and your needs? He's going to get you through somehow, some way, whether it's a big thing or someone bringing you a chicken salad dinner or picking you up and taking your child home or whatever. God's going to take care of you. Just stay in touch with the Lord. Keep the conversation open and watch what he does. Jesus says, you are worth more than many sparrows. How much more? He said, much more. Notice in Psalm 17, verse 8, he said, keep me as the apple of your eye. Hide me in the shadow of your wings. Isn't it something how God keeps talking about birds and wings under the shadow of the Almighty? Keep me as the apple of your eye. Deuteronomy 32, verse 10. Again, it speaks about the apple of your eye. The apple of your eye literally means daughter of the eye. In literal language, daughter of the eye. There's a little girl and her mother sitting on the couch. And the little girl was just mesmerized looking into her mother's eyes. And her mother asked her, said, honey, what are you staring at? And the little girl said this. She said, I see a little girl in your eyes, a reflection of herself. Well, you are a reflection of in God's eyes. He's got his eye on you. You are the daughter and son of his eyes. You are the apple of his eyes. How much do you value your eyesight? I see a little girl in your eyes. The apple of the eye, referring to the intimate relationship that we have with Jesus, with our God. But for that little girl to see an image of herself in her mother's eye, she had to be in close proximity. I don't see an image of myself in your eye or your eye. You're too far away. But let me get real close and start paying some attention, or you get real close to me. And I'll see a reflection. Friend, get close to God. Get close to God. He loves you so much. You're his child. You have been redeemed. When you pray and when you praise, there's a reflection of you in God's eyes. He's looking right at you, no matter what's going on. His eye is on the sparrow. I know he watches me. Thank you.
pastor said that we can't have our Christianity on a shelf for holidays and anniversaries. Today is the anniversary of my mother's death. And I don't think anyone could fault me if I just stayed in bed wrapped up in the covers today. And sometimes when I go out to minister, I minister for the Lord, and the byproduct is that the people Hallelujah. Are blessed. But today, this song that the pastor requested, His Eyes on the Sparrow, is keeping me and is blessing me, and I hope that it will bless you too.
Amen.
Why should I feel discouraged? And why should the shadow that God is watching over you and me. So let not your heart be troubled. His tender words I hear, and resting on God's goodness, I lose every one of my doubts and all my fears. Though by the path He leadeth, but one step I might see. I'm so glad that His eye is on the sparrow. Watching over you and me. So I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. And
I feel very impressed. I felt it last evening. I feel it right now. Some of you are going through some very difficult places. You don't know, I don't know where the journey of life's going to lead us. But there will be some valleys, some disappointments, some lonely places, physical, financial, marital, family, employment. This world is inundated with the virus of sin, mistake, and wrong. And not even Christians are exempt. But we have, or he has, us. And we have him, who is our shepherd, is going to take us through. Now this is what I saw in my imagination. People streaming also in your home, and people here with their hands out, putting their hands, so to speak, in my hands, and both of us putting our hands into the nail-scarred hands of Jesus. We need help, we need strength, and there is help and there is strength. We have but to ask. So this is what I'm going to ask you to do. I'm not going to take long, but I'm going to ask you all in just a moment to bow your heads and to pray. And for those who need help right now with some issue, to stand up, put your hands out. Don't come forward, just stay where you are, put your hands out, because if things were different, you would come forward, I would hold your hands, but I'm holding your hand. And again, he's holding both of our hands. And the blessing and the healing and the strength and the wisdom, whatever the need is going to come. So those of you who need his immediate help, would you stand up now and put your hands in my hands? Father God, you put it in my heart. You showed me people standing with hands outraised, putting their hands out into my hands. And I'm putting my hands into your hands. Dear Lord, there's a lot of us here this morning who need you. There's a lot of us streaming right now who are reaching out over the airways, and they're putting their hands in my hands as I put my hands in your hands. And together we're going to believe, where two or three are gathered together, there's going to be healing, there's going to be wholeness, encouragement, there's going to be strength, there's going to be a renewal, a victory, a restoring. Hallelujah to you, hallelujah to you. In the name of Jesus, my brothers and sisters here and streaming, be blessed, be healed, be encouraged. Whatever your need is, and you know what your need is, that's why you're standing. He knows what your need is, because his eye is on the sparrow, and he has never taken his eyes off of you, and he knows exactly what you need now. You have but to ask him in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, let us all say amen. Amen. You may be seated. Now, Lord willing, next Sunday is Thanksgiving Sunday, correct? Thanks.
Two more
Sundays.
Before Thanksgiving is 2 weeks.
I don't have a calendar before me, and I'm not even thinking, but at any rate, if I can get Corinne here next Sunday or the following Sunday, I'm going to try to do that. She would have come this morning. She said, "You going to church? I'm going to church." She told me that again last night. I don't think there's a place on the face of this earth that she talks about more, any one place, and a desire to be. You see, this is her church. You're her people. And I think I already told you, I told her, you get all these cards because they love you, because they know you love them. So dear friends, we're going forward. This world is reeling, but God is greater, and He has His hand on us, and we are going to more than make it. We're not getting Him through by the skin of our teeth. We're getting through with a wide and a great victory. Praise be to the Lord. Amen. Amen. Let's read the conclusion together. The value God has placed upon us is beyond measure. He watches over us and will love and care for us forever. He will keep us as the people, as the apple, the pupil of His eye, and hide us in the shadow of His wings. That's His promise. That's His promise to you. Claim it. Claim it. Read it often. Read it out loud to Him in prayer. He loves you, friend. Amen.
Reggie, leave that up on the screen, please. In a moment, I'm going to pronounce the benediction. But before I do, Pastor, I want to say to you what a fantastic job you did this morning under conditions. I know from my own experience, when I prepare sermons, as I prepare to minister to you, God is ministering to me in preparation for those sermons, and I feel that I'm being preached to as I'm preparing. And I think that was the case for you this morning. This message was for you, Pastor. The message that you prepared for us, God was delivering to you, to Corinne. He wants you to know that His eye is on you. His eye is on Corinne. He knows what you're going through. He knows what each and every one of us are going through. We're going through various different things this morning. I think of Wilson. He passed just a few years ago. And I know the pain of when we lose loved ones, the pain of those that are sick and shut in. Many have been affected by relatives and even yourselves affected by COVID. And again, loved ones who are hospitalized. But remember, His eye is on us. He cares for us. He knows what we are going through. And I want us to just remember that throughout this week. When we feel down, when we feel frustrated, when we feel that we don't have anywhere to go, to know that God's eye is on us. And Pastor, Amen. He says, the value God has placed upon us is beyond measure. We cannot measure that. He watches over each and every one of us, and He will love and care for us regardless of where we are.
Wayne. Moment. I want to thank everyone here and streaming who have sent in funds for the drive-thru. When's the drive-thru again?
Next Saturday.
Next Saturday. Over $4,000 has come in, and we're so thankful that we're going to be able to have another drive-thru giving out the food baskets for the holiday, for Thanksgiving. And I want to thank everybody that is tithing. We're paying our bills. We're making it. But we're not way ahead like we were at one time. But I'm not complaining. I'm thanking God, and I'm thanking you, your faithful people. Whether you're able to come to church or whether you're not, you're still serving the Lord with your finances, with your devotion, with your love, and with your service. And I thank you. God bless you.
And as Pastor said, a part of giving is a part of worshiping. So let us continue to worship as we give our tithe and offering. Many of you have opted to give online, and you can continue to do that on the home page. At the top is a drop down box that says donations. You can click on that, and it gives you the various different methods that you can donate. Those of you who are here and still like to give paper donations as you exit this morning, you can just drop them in the offering plate at the exit door. Or those of you who like to stop by the office during the course of the week, you can do that as well. Drop off your offering. The office is open Monday through Friday. And we want to, and as Pastor said about the offering, but also building the funds, we're taking a lot of precautions to make sure that we keep you safe. We've installed about a month ago air purifiers throughout the building to keep those that come in. And we're going to be in compliance with the county and the state. And we want to make sure folks wear their masks and wear them properly. But most importantly, we're going to pray for one another. So let us stand now for the benediction. And those who are here, as you're leaving, we encourage you to leave through the exterior doors to your left, my right. If you do have to go back into the building to use a restroom, we understand, but we encourage you to leave and then not to socialize in the parking lot. So let us go to the Lord in prayer as I pronounce the benediction at this time. Unto God's gracious mercy and protection, we commit you in the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, let us all say, Amen.